Jeff, just in looking at your new lines and reading your quotes from yesterday, it sounds like you're challenging some of your younger guys to step up and take more of a leadership role on this team and production role on the ice.
Well, I don't think it's just the younger guys. I think it's just a matter of, we've been good. We've been in every game except the Vancouver game. I think we've played lots of good hockey, but we got to step up and make a play throughout the course of the game to make sure we win these games instead of come on the wrong side of them. And certainly with, the three young guys together gives them a chance when they're going. They can play lots, but they also got to carry that line on their own a little bit as a group, I think they're ready for it. I think they're ready to be difference makers in the league. I think Tats and Nike and Z have been a real good line going all the way back to the beginning of last year. They spent lots of time together, and I think the other two lines can be effective, so we'll see.
How crucial is it that some of those guys do step up and become leaders? Henrik Zetterberg certainly has been a great one, but can't do it himself. If this team wants to be going in the direction you need it to go, how crucial is that?
Well, it's critical that we continue progress of guys besides Z. Z is still one of the better players in the league, in my opinion. He's shown that this year. Carried the team to a win in Vegas, has done it multiple times, but we need the other guys to be able to do that as well. And so, I think the maturation process and whether that's Tats Nike, whether that's AA Larks Manta, we need those guys that have that high-end offensive ability to step up and make those high-end offensive plays.
What led you to decide to put these lines together and keep them together and let guys develop some kind of chemistry for a while here?
Well, I going into the year, I talked to myself, I guess, about not changing lines too much. And then you get into a rut a little bit where you're not winning, and you start trying to help your guys as much as you can, and sometimes you might overdo it. And I just said, we're going to stay with what we got. You guys got to make plays. You guys got to step up and make sure that you're getting the job done. That was kind of how the decision process went.
In probably limited minutes, how can Martinburg make a difference on that fourth line?
Well, I think, the thing with Marty is I think Marty's, it's all based on confidence. And when Marty's got lots of confidence, he plays real good. Sometimes you get moved down the line, you lose some of your confidence. And him and I had a conversation yesterday. Mitch Marner plays in the fourth line in Toronto. He's a threat every time he's on the ice. So it gives you four lines that have threats. Marty can do the same thing. He can be a threat every time he's on the ice and then carry that confidence forward to the power play. He can be impactful in the power play for sure. He's just got to make sure that he enjoys every minute of hockey. Sometimes the stress can beat you down a little bit. Let's just enjoy it. He plays in the NHL. Let's enjoy it and go out and use the abilities that he has.
How well do you know Chase Ballasy? You've had him at Western. Looks like he's going to make his debut tonight.
Yeah, Chase was one of my first two recruits to Western. When I got the job, he was still uncommitted at the U.S. national team, and he came over I think it was a Sunday, and spent a day with me and ended up committing, and I think it helped change the program there at Western. He's a really smart, really, really good, solid hockey player, good two-way player, real good with the puck, so I'm pumped for him to be able to get an opportunity.
The challenge that the Panthers present. You saw what they did the other night, of course.
Well, they got two, real, real good lines. That's not take away from the other lines, but obviously, the Barkov line. I had a chance to see Dadonov up front in the World Championships last year. He was excellent, excellent power play guy. Huberto's a real good player, and the Trocheck line. Trocheck's one of the better young players in the league. So, those two lines present big time challenges. I've talked to people that have played Florida. They think they're one of the better teams in our division. So we got a challenge tonight, but that's every night in the league. You got to go out, you got to play great hockey. Usually it ends up tied in the third, then you got to make a play, and you got to find a way to make a play to make sure you're on the right side of that result.
Having said that, Blashill, the numbers say they've given up more shots than anybody in the league, and they could be had on the power play. How can you take advantage of those things with your team tonight?
Well, I think, when we're playing our best, we're a pressure team, and when you pressure people, you cause mistakes. And so we got to make sure that our pressure's heavy. We got to make sure that we're creating opportunities off the forecheck. We got to find a way to more offense. It's there to be had. We got to make sure that we're executing when we get those opportunities. And then our power play's got to be better than it was the other night from a retrieval standpoint. We had about 12 unforced errors. Can't have unforced errors on the power play. You got to know where your guys are at in the retrievals. You got to make sure they go to the right spot, so that it's automatic where the retrievals are, and then you're not always going to score on the power play. You can't have 12 unforced errors.